learning outcomes. After studying this module, you shall be able to know what are photocopied documents. You will be able to know the technique involved in production of photocopied document, and you will be able to analyze the various photocopied documents. Introduction. Photocopied documents are the one which can be forged easily, and its detection is an easy task. The detection of forgery by photocopying or xeroxing cannot be done just by analyzing the photocopied question document, but it also requires the examination of the machine by which the photocopy is done. And other thing is, in the machine should be in the same state as it was when the photocopy was done. The paper used for the Xerox is also analyzed for any specific quality and individuality. All the parts of the Xerox machine is analyzed during the examination of forgery by photocopy. One main aspect of the photocopy document is that they cannot photocopy the watermark present in the original document, which can be one of the features of identification of the original document. The forger try to develop same type of watermark by some other method, like using oils or acid to make the portion of the paper thin as in the original where watermark is present. The photocopy machine is used for making copies of the original document present, and these documents are not original but are Xerox and contains the characteristic features of the machine through which it has been photocopied. There are different methods by which the photocopied documents can be prepared, and it can be said that there are different principles on which photocopy machine works. Some of these techniques involve photocopying of the documents, like chemical process, thermal process, electrostatic process. The characteristics which should be studied during analysis of photocopied document are type of toner and its characteristics, type of paper used, any special structure of the paper, gripping instrument in analysis, study of markings produced by the photocopying machine, appearance of black streaks and its study, the clearance of the photocopied document, study of feathering of ink, any overwriting should be looked for. Now let us see the types of techniques involved in different photocopying machines. The different techniques mentioned in the introduction part will be discussed further, like the one chemical process. Light sensitive paper is exposed to the original document, and the specific type of a chemical composition is applied to it for the reaction between the original document and the paper on which it should be photocopied. Due to the reaction of the chemical applied and the use of light sensitive paper, the photocopy of the original document is produced. Next is thermal process. In this technique of photocopying, paper having different chemical is used, and these paper are placed in contact with the original document to be photocopied and are exposed with infrared lamp, which exposes the paper with varying degree of heat. Due to this heating of the paper and the corresponding places of the paper on which the photocopy is to be made also gets heated up, and thus produces a photocopy of the original document. The best example of this technique is thermofax. Next technique is electrostatic process. In today's world, the use of electrostatic type photocopy machine are very popular. Xerox Corporation has started Xeroxography machine based on the principle of electrostatic process in 1950. Nowadays, more than 40 manufacturer companies are producing more than 200 variants of the Xerograph machine. Electrostatic process is based on physical and electrostatic phenomena, due to which the static electricity produces an opposite charge on the paper conductivity surface. The above mentioned process is also used in thermofacts along with its use in xerography, in which there is a coating of selenium on a metallic plate which acts as photoconductor and attracts toner to produce a Xerox. Now let us learn about identifying individual photocopiers. There are three photocopier examination determining whether or not two or more copies come from same machine, or determining whether or not a particular machine produced the copies, and determining the approximate date of the copies. Article by James Gerhardt deals with using fusing ruler defects to help in identify a photocopy with its source machine. He states that fusing ruler defects should be considered a key component in identification of photocopiers. Like any mechanical device, a copier will develop its own individual characters with time and wear, which often will result in the introduction of a unique constellation of marks onto a copy. Knowing how to find and interpret these marks may enable a document examiner to associate a copy with the machine that made it. Copy machine mechanism effort several areas where defects cause individualizing features to be transferred to copies. Some are ephemeral and require samples made close in time. Others are fairly stable but may be eliminated by repair or service on the machine. It might be necessary to study the repair record of a particular copier before observed features can be properly interpreted. The first area where unique marking can occur is on the glass imaging window or platen. The glass can become solid and smudged with fingerprints, adhesives from tape or labels, opaquing solutions and general debris. Such materials in sufficient quantity can produce a constellation of unique marks on each copy. Cleaning of the glass window may remove these marks. To rule out this possibility, it is prudent to obtain for comparison known sample prepared on the machine close to the same time as the question copy. The glass window may acquire more permanent marks in the form of scratches or pits, provided these are not so obvious as to annoy the user and lead to replacement of the glass. They will be present for the life of the copier. The rubber blacking blanket that holds the original document in place on the glass window can also be a source of unique feature. It can become solidated or damaged through prolonged use. If the entire imaging area is not covered, a portion of blanket with its unique feature will be reproduced. However, with the standard or legal sized original, the blanket is not usually within the imaging area. Occasionally, a speck of dust or other matter will adhere to the imaging lens and produce a characteristic mark on copies. This type of defect is rare and may be so noticeable as to lead a service call. The light sensitive imaging drum can be a source of unique feature as well. Pits, scratches or marks on the emission drum will produce characteristic marks and dots on the copies. Unlike other imaging defects, drum defects will not appear in the same place on the copy. The drum makes revolutions with each copy and does not land in the same rest position after each rotation. Sign of drum defect will always be same distance from top and bottom or from left to right. Margins depending on the paper fed direction but will vary along the axis of fed and may not appear on all copies. High speed copiers have large drums that make three different images at a time. Such machines may only reproduce a drum defect on every third copy. Paper fed grippers and rollers can also distinctive impressions on the copies. This generally occurs when the paper is not seated properly in the paper tray or the tension on the paper fed device is out of adjustment. These marks are frequently in the form of indented impression in the paper rather than a visible toner mark. The impression can be observed with oblique light and may be recovered with an electrostatic detection device. Now student, we will learn about the comparison sample. A forensic document examiner rarely has the luxury of access to an actual suspect copier. It is necessary to base examination on samples taken from machine or machines in question. Several samples from a copier help to establish with each of tiny marks present on nearly all copies are repeated individual features and which are random electrical misfires. Extraneous marks are nearly always present. In order to capture every significant defect and to eliminate meaningless random marks, an forensic document examiner must intercompare several sample pages. Aggregate samples can generally be obtained by following some instructions like with a rubber backing blanket pressed in a place against the glass imaging window, activate the machine and make at least 6 consecutive copies. I repeat 6 consecutive copies because they are very important in purpose of comparison. The number of copies are more, the comparison becomes more good. We will have a lot of characteristics to be copied. So the examination lead to a very correct and perfect conclusion. Number them in order they were made. Set the machine on its darkest setting and repeat. Set the machine on the lightest setting and repeat. Place a piece of blank white paper on the imaging window and repeat the first 3 steps so that we can get the individual characteristics of the machine on the paper, with the help of which the examination becomes more easy as well as correct. It also is very helpful to research the repair and cleaning history of copier. If it has undergone significant repair and cleaning since the elapsed time of the preparation of question documents, it may be necessary to locate copies made on the machine prior to the cleaning service. So, if we will know that already the machine has undergone a lot of time servicing, so we can have the record, we can check from there what are the changes done in the machine and what are the characters which may be developed after the repairing. Knowing the paper's fed direction, long or short side, can also be of assistance. Now let us learn about the comparison. In conducting a comparison of question copy to samples from a known machine or machines, The forensic document examiner may start with either the samples or the question document. It is useful to overlay the document under study with a sheet of a clear plastic film and create a template by recording the non-imaging marks with ink dots on the film. The template can be placed over other copies to establish whether the same set of accidentals is present and to identify any different marks that appears. The documents can also be scanned, overlaid and compared using the layers functions of graphics software program. In considering similarities and differences in a copier comparison, the examiner must take into account that copying machine nearly always make a random marks on the product. Therefore, the question documents and the known sample will almost always have some differences, the presence of which does not mean the copies are produced, does not mean the copies were produced on two of different copiers. If a sufficient number of consistently repeating marks are present on both question and known documents, the document examiner may still conclude they have a common origin or source. An absence of any similarities between the question and known copies does not necessarily warrant an elimination of the suspect copier. The machine may have been cleaned or repaired between the time that the question copies were made and the known samples were taken. While such a lack of similarities may preclude an association, it may not justify elimination of the particular copier. Knowledge of maintenance to machine is always helpful. There is no set number of similarities needed to effect or an identification of a copying machine, because it is not necessarily the number that determines the matter. It is the type of defect that carries the most weight. The determination of significance must be in the judgment of the document examiner, and it is based on study and experience. Dear student, now we will learn about the examination of photocopy document. For the purpose of analysis of question photocopy documents, the following points must be taken into consideration. First is, the first most important thing during analysis is to identify the type of process involved in photocopying process. And for this, the analysis of paper is very necessary. In electroflex techniques, the paper having zinc oxide is used. For xerography, simple paper is used. For thermal process, the paper which is heat sensitive and has a specific chemical composition is used. So, by the analysis of the paper and the type of process involved can be determined. The basic qualities of paper like color, weight, texture, tone, trademark, etc. should be analyzed. To identify the type of the photocopy machine, its model, etc. is also one of the important aspects of the photocopy document examination. There are class characteristics which are found in the photocopy documents, and these class characteristics are made by the machinery of the photocopying machine. The roller and the gripping instruments of the machine make some of the important marks on the photocopy paper, which are specific to a group of photocopying machine, and sometimes due to wear and tear, they produce some unique feature which can even identify the photocopying machine in a specified manner. Due to the design and placement of the roller in the machine produce specific marks which are mainly the black streaks which are produced on the front of the photocopied portion. The above mentioned feature along with these features can be used for identification of type and model of the photocopying machine. The study of toner and the paper may also be fruitful in identification process of the type and the model of the photocopying. The establishment of the question photocopying to the question photocopy machine is also an important point during the investigation of these cases, and the machines should be seized as early as possible because the owner of the forger may cause some changes to the machines which obviates the change of the positive identification of the machine with the question document. In photocopied document, there may be individual marking caused by the wear and tear of its machinery with time, like the drum, roller, glass tube, gripping instrument may produce some specific markings developed in them with time. As we know that two machines cannot produce same kind of markings by the process of wear and tear. As in other examination, the alterations and other forgery related crimes can take place in the documents involving the photocopy documents. The portion of the photocopy document which has even obliterated or erased appears clearer than on the simple paper. The overwriting and the feathering of ink can be more easily identified in the photocopied document than in other documents. For collecting the samples for analysis of the photocopied documents, the photocopy machine should be activated for 5 to 10 minutes and blank Xerox should be taken from it. One thing that should be taken care of is that the machine should not be changed in any manner, or in simpler words, the integrity of the machine should be maintained. Now we will learn about the analysis of paper can be done on the basis of points just discussed. Now we can examine or analyze the photocopied document, like the instruments which can produce markings, characteristics of marking. Like gripping instrument, its character is that it is the one which grips the paper, and thus its marking will always be present in the paper. In the case shown below, there are very slight gripping marking on the borders of both samples and the markings are of the same pattern. Next is roller. The roller rolls over the paper and lifts its marks, which are same in both sample with even distribution of toners. Next is black streaks. These are due to the design and placement of the roller in the machinery. Next is the drum. The drum is rotating, and thus when it comes in contact of paper, it leaves the marks and hair in the samples, provided the marks produced are same. Next is glass roller. The glass roller rod also produces some minute markings which can be studied by magnifying glass only. So, the study of all characteristics mentioned and the machine and the experts, I repeat, and the expertise in the study of these documents can help us to identify the forgery if tried to meet in any manner. Dear student, now let us summarize what we have learned in this module. Photocopied documents are the one which can be forged easily, and its detection is not an easy task. The paper used for xerographing is also analyzed for any specific quality and individuality. All the parts of Xerox machine is analyzed during the examination of forgery by photocopying. The forger may try to develop some type of watermark by some other methods using oils or grease or even acids to make the portion of paper thin, as in the original where watermark is present. The photocopying machine is used for making copies of the original documents present, and these documents are not original but are Xerox and contain the characteristic features of the machine through which it has been photocopied. There are different methods by which the photocopied documents can be prepared, or it can be said that there are different principles on which different photocopying machine works. Some of the techniques involved in photocopying of documents are chemical process, thermal process, and electrostatic process, as we have discussed in detail what these processes are. The first most important thing during analysis is to identify the type of process involved in photocopy process, and for this the analysis of paper is very necessary. In electrophagous technique, the paper having zinc oxide is used. For xerography, simple paper is used. For thermal process, the paper which is heat sensitive and has a specific chemical composition is used. So by analysis of paper and the type of process involved can be identified. The basic qualities of the paper like color, weight, texture, toner, trademark, etc. should be analyzed. To identify the type of the photocopying machine, its model, etc. is also one of the important aspects of photocopying document examination. Thank you.